Faith Whittlesey left an indelible mark on the history of our country. She served as an elected official, ambassador, and leader of the American Swiss Foundation for nearly 30 years.
She believed that in order to have a meaningful participation in the political process, you had to have a governing set of principles, and she surely did.
Faith's modest upbringing in the 1940s and 50s was defined by rigorous devotion to reading, studying, and mastering classical piano. Her parents instilled in her a robust work ethic. From an early age, Faith defied convention and earned full tuition scholarships to study at Wells College and then the University of Pennsylvania Law School. She also won fellowships to travel abroad and study in Europe.
She graduated top in her class from Penn, a class of 146. She was one of six women.
Faith's desire to serve and entrepreneurial spirit led her to a life in politics. She served in various appointed positions, including as assistant U.S. attorney from 1970 to 1972. In 1972, she was elected to the Pennsylvania State Legislature. She won re-election in 1974.
Faith is what one could call a conviction politician and stateswoman. She operated from a basic framework of right and wrong, and she spoke and acted on her convictions.
To remain true to her ideals, Faith broke with party establishment in 1976 and supported Ronald Reagan in the Republican presidential primary. In 1980, she took a leadership role in Reagan's campaign for the swing state of Pennsylvania. President Reagan rewarded Faith's loyalty with the offer to serve as ambassador to Switzerland. Her knowledge of the German language and prior experience in Europe made her uniquely qualified for this position.
Everything that Faith did, she did with a high degree of personal conviction. She demanded it from everyone else.
Her skills as a politician were an asset in her role as ambassador to the Swiss sister republic.
She was an excellent diplomat, privately and publicly.
She had a unique ability to connect with people formally and informally. She led American-style sing-alongs from the piano.
She relished bringing people together during her legendary sing-alongs where she played the piano. And what better way to bring people together, bring goodwill, friendship, and diplomacy?
As the sitting U.S. ambassador, she also hosted the highly scripted Geneva Summit of November 1985 when President Reagan met Soviet General Secretary Mikhail Gorbachev.
She was principled, and those principles were the same as the principles that Ronald Reagan believed in.
When she returned to the United States, Ambassador Whittlesey applied President Reagan's philosophy of empowering individuals instead of government bureaucracies and created a new model of citizen-to-citizen diplomacy through the private sector.
Faith had an amazing knack for spotting emerging talent, and she brought out the best in everyone. Above all, she was a true friend to Switzerland.
Over the next three decades, she identified and mentored more than 1,200 emerging leaders through the American Swiss Foundation's Young Leaders Conference. For 28 years, Faith was intimately engaged in every detail of recruiting participants and planning conferences. She attended every conference, personally fostering opportunities for dialogue and communication.
She had an incredible gift for bringing people together. She built bridges wherever she went, and now there are hundreds of leaders in both countries who are ready to carry her legacy forward.
We will remember Faith for her compassion, conviction, and courage.
She dedicated her life to her causes with passion, loyalty. She gave her time and energy. Her very strong values were her compass in deciding upon courses of action.
We will remember Faith for her power to connect people across borders and party lines. Over the course of her life, Faith remained open to possibilities. Hers was an unplanned life, motivated by her curiosity and willingness to take risks. She approached every interaction as an opportunity to learn and to teach.
Faith was fond of saying that Ginger Rogers did everything that Fred Astaire did, only backwards in high heels. That was Faith's life. She was a prosecutor, a mother, an ambassador. She was someone who brought people together.
Faith achieved great success in her professional life. At the same time, her greatest joy was her family. Widowed at an early age, she took great pride in her 3 children and her 10 grandchildren.
We called her a people collector because she always had this large array of people that didn't necessarily fit the mold of her political or personal beliefs, but she was always very kind to them.
Faith's life was rooted in strongly held principles and ideals. She modeled civility, humility, and grace. Her legacy inspires us to follow her example.
Faith Whittlesey was an outstanding personality in Swiss-American friendship. She brought people together.
She was a nurturer. She invested in people. And the value of that I see every day as ambassador to Switzerland.
I think she would like to be remembered most as a believing Christian, someone who truly did love God. And I think we all saw that in her faith and everything that she did.
In our little corner of the world, make whatever contribution we can all of us make together to peaceful outcomes and deeply respectful discourse between the peoples of 2 exceptional nations and with a decent respect for the opinions of mankind. Thank you all very, very much.
Diamonds on the windshield as heaven starts to cry. In his rearview mirror, his angel waves goodbye. She knows he's gotta go. She knows he's one of them. Brothers of the highway, children of the wind. That Detroit diesel pirate ship goes blowing out again. Sailing toward the setting sun, freedom's their best friend. Brothers of the highway, children of the wind.